Hello dear students, welcome back to this channel. Today we are going to be discussing how you can develop the habit of studying for 10 to 12 hours. Now I know so many months are remaining to your examination, and even though you know that it is the right thing to do, you know that right now you should be studying for 10 to 12 hours, you should be putting in all the effort, but I also know that when you must be trying to study, it sometimes gets boring. It must be possible that the concepts are so very difficult that sometimes we just get scared of all of these concepts and we don't want to do them anymore. We want to do the fun stuff, we want to see social media, we want to hang out with our friends. So how do you actually develop this habit of studying for 10 to 12 hours? The sooner you start developing this habit, the sooner you get into the groove of studying every single day, the better chances you have to clear the examination. So you really need to develop this habit of studying. How do you do that? We are going to be discussing that in this video. I'm going to be sharing a lot of the mindsets as well as a lot of the simple techniques that you can follow, which are going to help you in developing this habit. Let's start off. The first thing is you have to be a little realistic. I'm talking about developing the habit of studying. So if you have to develop any new habit, it is going to take you 21 days at least to build that habit. For 21 days, you will have to practice even if it is uncomfortable. And then you will automatically build that momentum of doing it on a regular basis, right? So we have to build that habit. Now, in order to build that habit, you have to be a little realistic. What do I mean by realistic? See, right now, it may be possible that you are studying only 3 hours, 4 hours, or maybe you're not studying at all, you are just going to your coaching or you're taking online coaching. So probably your study quota right now is very, very low. Okay, now if your study quota is so low, most of the time that you are having, you're either wasting it in casual stuff like social media or hanging out with friends. Now you want to change all of that. You want to devote all of that time to your studies. Okay, so first of all, you will have to be a little realistic. You can't just have a target that tomorrow onwards you are going to be studying for 10 to 12 hours and then do it. Okay, it may be possible that you set such a target and then next day you try to do for 10 to 12 hours of study and you actually achieve it. But what is going to happen is that it is going to burn you out and then you will quit after that. So let's not do that. Let's go one step at a time. Okay, so what you can try to do is that probably for 1 week period, you can try to study for 4 hours if you're not studying at all. Or maybe if you're studying a little bit, then you can try to study for 6 hours, right? Then every single day, try consistently studying for 4 hours or 6 hours, whatever is the next higher level target for you. Okay, then after 1 week of practice, then increase it by 1 more hour or 2 more hours. Okay, so if you're doing 6 hours, then do 8 hours, right? Like that, if you try to study a little bit longer every single week, it is going to be still a little relaxing for you. Doing 10 hours, 12 hours, suddenly it is going to be too much for your head. So let's set realistic targets and try to achieve them. The second thing is be a little forgiving to yourself. See, as we just discussed, this is a habit that we have to build. So this is something which you will have to do consistently over months and months till your examination, right? Initially, when you're going to try to develop this habit, you might lapse. Okay, even when we start going to the gym or we start doing that workout or we start eating clean or any new habit that you develop. Okay, initially, because it is absolutely new, that is the reason why you might do it 1 or 2 days nicely and then you might fail a little bit, right? So even now, if you're thinking that you're going to start studying 6 hours or 7 hours every single day, maybe you do it 1 day, maybe you do it 2 days, maybe the third day you might skip it a little bit. It may be possible instead of 6 hours, you do only 4 hours. So whenever you do these kind of mistakes, or some days if you just don't feel like studying and you don't do it at all, you are going to feel guilty. That is just natural, okay? But when you do feel guilty, take time, take 5 minutes, take 10 minutes, sit with yourself and tell yourself that so what? What's done is done, we can't change it, but we have to try again tomorrow, okay? So even if you have a lapse of 1 day or 2 days here and there, you have to get back up tomorrow and then you will have to try it all over again, right? The most important thing is that you don't give up in building this habit. Even a small progress of 1% every single day is going to compound into you developing a very brilliant habit for yourself, which is going to have everlasting effects for your examination. So let's just not give up. If you're doing some mistakes here and there, forgive yourself and move on. The next thing is that you will have to be ready to endure the pain because it is not going to be comfortable. See, right now your comfort zone is that you don't study that much. Let's accept this. So this is your comfort zone. Now you have to change it. You have to get out of your comfort zone. Success happens outside the comfort zone. So you will have to step out of it and it is going to be uncomfortable. You will not feel like studying. Studying is going to feel boring. Studying is going to feel difficult. यू माइट सी योर फ्रेंड्स हैंगिंग आउट, यू माइट सी दैट सोशल मीडिया पे ये भी हो रहा है, वो भी हो रहा है, यू माइट वॉन्ट टू कैच अप ऑन एवरीथिंग दैट इज हैपनिंग ऑन सोशल मीडिया. यू विल हैव ऑल ऑफ दोज क्रेविंग्स, यू विल हैव दोज टेम्पटेशंस, बट यू हैव टू बी प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर इट. सो बिफोर यू मेक अप योर एंटायर माइंड दैट यू हैव टू डेवलप दिस हैबिट, प्लीज डिसाइड एंड ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड, बी अवेयर ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी कंफर्टेबल, इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी एन ईजी थिंग. इफ इट वॉज सो ईजी एवरीबडी वुड हैव बीन स्टडिंग 10 hours एंड 12 hours राइट नाउ. इट इज गोइंग टू बी चैलेंजिंग, यू विल बी टेम्प्टेड बाई social media, you will be tempted by your friends, you will be tempted by your bed, your comfort zone, your sleep, everything. Most of the people, they're going to be sleeping. Most of the people, they're going to be sitting on social media right now. Most of the people, they're going to be hanging out with their friends. But if you endure this pain right now, later on you will succeed in your exams, and there is going to be nothing like it, no better pleasure like succeeding in your examination. So you will have to decide whether you want to take the pain and endure it right now, or whether you want to save the pain for later on when the results come out. The next tip is that you will have to reward yourself. Okay, so throughout the day, let's say you're setting a target initially that you're going to be studying 6 hours or 8 hours. That is how you're going to be developing the habit till you reach that 10-hour goal or 12-hour goal, right? Now, after the entire day of hard work, reward yourself. I feel the best way you can reward yourself is by hiding your phone and then later on giving yourself the chance to use it. So that means throughout the day, try to complete those 6 hours or 8 hours of study. And then once you've completed that entire thing, only after that, give yourself the liberty to use your phone. Only after that, check the social media. Only after that, you go on YouTube or your Netflix. Only after that, you chat with your friends or your girlfriend or your boyfriend. Now, this is a thing that is also going to keep you away from distraction. It is going to keep you fully focused in your study. At the same time, till the end of the day, you will have something to look forward to. So that is going to drive you to complete your study as fast as possible. The next wonderful and most magical tip that I can give you, which I have practiced personally, is to track yourself. Now, initially when I was preparing for my CA Inter, at that time it used to be called IPCC. Initially when, you know, these exams are 3 months away or 4 months away, at that time it is very difficult to sit down and study. I understand. So at that time, I had to just make sure that I study enough so this time is not wasted. So what I used to do is, I used to have that small little spiral binded diary, and every single day I used to actually note down from what time till what time I'm studying. Okay, this was my way of tracking myself. Okay, so if I would sit down at 8 o'clock in the morning, I would write it down 8 o'clock, and then if I get up at 9 o'clock, then I would write 8 to 9, 1 hour. Okay, and then whatever topics I completed, I would write down there. So basically, I maintained this small little diary throughout the day. Whatever time I sat down to study, whatever time I got up, I wrote it down, and whatever I completed, I wrote it down. At the end of the day, I would calculate all my effective hours of study, and I was able to see how much did I actually study. If suppose for 3-4 days I was doing 6 hours, 6 hours, 7 hours, 7 hours, and suddenly there was a drop and I only studied for 4 hours, I really felt bad, and then I evaluated what happened wrong on that day and how can I improve it, right? Also, throughout the period of time, it kept me motivated. Even if a few days I was not able to study well, I could see that I had a track record of studying every single day for so many hours, right? So when you write something down, it registers in your brain. You're able to track how well you have been performing, okay? And it really motivates you to keep it going. So this is something which you can definitely try. The next tip for you is, make yourself a study plan. Now see, just before the examination, whether it was your school exams or whether it was your college exams or whether it was these professional exams, when it is very, very close, we have this huge pressure on top of us. And when we have just 1 week left, or when we have just 15 days left, or when we have just 1 day left, we study so well. Even if we are not in the habit of studying, we try to complete the entire course in that 1 day. Sometimes we study 12 hours. Sometimes we study 20 hours in a day. Sometimes we take all-nighters and study. Why is that? It is because of pressure. So even if we don't like pressure, even if we don't like stress, it definitely has an impact on our motivation. It definitely gets us working. Okay, so create a fake pressure for yourself. Create a fake stress for yourself. That is going to motivate you to study. How are you going to do that now? Well, that is going to be by creating a study plan. Okay, so if you create a study plan for yourself for the next 3 months or 4 months, whatever time is remaining till your examination, that study plan, if you break it down into monthly goals and then to weekly goals and then to daily goals, then that is going to give you pressure. If you do not complete that daily target, then your weekly target is going to be affected. If you do not complete your weekly target, your monthly target is going to be affected. And if you do not complete your monthly target, then your entire study plan is going to be Yeah, and if your entire study plan is messed, then of course, how are you going to get your result, right? So accordingly, create a study plan for yourself. With respect to study plan, I have already created a video. You can check it out. I'll link it here in the I button, and also I'll put it in the description box below. Accordingly, create a study plan for yourself, break it into daily goals, and then try to achieve that daily goal. The next important point is, don't compare yourself with anybody else. Everybody who's giving the examination is in different stages of their journeys. Right, some of them, they have completed coaching, some of them, they have not completed coaching, some of them, they have already given the examination a couple of times, so they are already in stress, they are already in pressure, so they are studying more. Moreover, if you look here and there, then you will not be able to fully focus in your examination and your preparation. See, you cannot control what other people are doing. You cannot control how many hours they are studying, whether they are going to pass in the examination or not. Moreover, you don't even know exactly whether they are actually properly studying or not. It may be possible that they are not properly studying, right? See, these factors, how the other people are performing, that is not in our control. So let's just not think about it. Let's focus on the things that we can actually control. The most important person that you can compete with is what you were one day before. So if yesterday you were able to study 6 hours, today you try to study 6.5 hours or 7 hours, right? Then after a week, try to improve it to 8 hours. After another week, try to study for 9 hours, and so on and so forth. Try to improve yourself. The next crucial tip is that try to make studying fun and interesting. Okay, initially when you're going to study with that fat book, a practical subject or a theory subject, these concepts are going to be new. They might be difficult. They also might be boring. You might feel sleepy when you're doing it, or you might feel very, very scared when you're doing all of these new concepts. Okay, so try to develop the interest of studying. Okay, when you are interested into something, then you really want to give it more and more time. So if you develop that interest of studying, then it is definitely going to increase your hours of study also. Now, how are you going to do that? Well, see, sometimes if you don't feel like studying, if it is a theory subject, start speaking loudly. Start explaining those concepts to yourself. This is a technique that is definitely going to help you. Okay, sometimes if you don't feel like doing the practical subjects or theory subjects, just watch a lecture. Okay, just watch a marathon lecture. So here at least something is better than nothing. Sometimes if you're bored, then instead of sitting at the same place, try changing the place of studying a study at some other spot. Sometimes you might discuss the concepts with your friends. That will also help you in understanding them better. When you know you will have to discuss it with your friends, you will work better, you will prepare better. You can do group study, but then just make sure that this group study doesn't become a fun activity. Okay, you have to actually study. Another way that you can make the subject interesting for you is to actually develop interest in that subject. So if you're doing costing, then think like you have the factory and you are trying to save the cost of your own factory. If you're studying income tax, then think that you are the person who's earning the salary, or you are making profits in business, and then you're trying to save your own taxes. So if you're studying law, then think like you are the shareholder of the company. So if you put yourself in the subject, if you create a story around it, then it is going to be interesting for you. And if the subject is interesting for you, then you will spend more and more time doing it. So these were all the different tips and tricks that are going to help you in developing that habit of studying for 10 to 12 hours. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any more questions, doubts, let me know in the comment section down below. If you haven't subscribed the channel yet, then make sure you do subscribe the channel. Also hit a like on this video if it has helped you. Also share it with your friends. I'm going to see you again in another video. Meanwhile, take care of yourself. Bye bye.